Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Alice Rita. To only and returning subscribers, I'm glad that you are here to watch my video today. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to modify your EndNote bibliography. And what do I mean by modify? I mean how to add the missing information in your EndNote bibliography. So if you're writing a report, you can get a feedback from your supervisor, something like, oh, your bibliography list is not consistent. For my PhD dissertation, one of the corrections I got was to make sure that I have a consistent bibliography list. And what makes it that even though I'm using EndNote, the bibliography list is not consistent. So there are instances whereby your EndNotes have a missing DOI. So I'm going to close this. Or maybe the author name is not correctly spelled in the journal. Or maybe the journal name, maybe some documents has the journal name completely written out and some not. Anyway, I'm going to show you a document. This is a blank document which I'm going to generate some random references so that you can see what I mean. So here I have this folder that contains about 9 paper, and I'm just going to highlight 5 and reference these 5, and then we can look at their bibliography. Let me zoom into this. Okay, so we have these 5 different references, and you can see that the first one contain a DOI, the second contain a DOI, which is good, the third also had a DOI, the fourth had a DOI, and the fifth did not have a DOI, or it contained an hyperlink instead. Also, let's look at another thing that is different between these 5 different references. You can see here, the journal name is completely written out as a Nature review under the category of molecular cell biology. However, if you look at the second one, it's a proceeding of National Academy of Science, USA. But if you look at it, the journal name has been abbreviated while the first one was written in full. And if we look at which other one again, Nature of Chemical Biology, this seems to be completely written well. This one, okay. So we have one out of these 5 that the journal name has been abbreviated. We have that this same one did not contain the page. Okay, it contained the information for the page number and the issue number. So we want to make this consistent. What I'm going to then do is to go to EndNote. I'm going to minimize this now and expand the EndNote reference page. So what I'm going to do is to then update the reference from EndNote. Why is it that I did not choose to do the update from Word? For instance, this one that contains the hyperlink, if you just delete that and continue working, I think I'm making it more consistent now. If your instant formatting is on, immediately you add a new reference. For instance, let's assume I'm adding a new reference now. Let's choose the 6th one on the list or any of this. Okay, so if I'm choosing Lee, let me click add as reference. What will happen is that the previous one, can you see that that hyperlink has returned? And even this, there's an error. Sorry, let me go back here. Let me now add one more reference. So if I add one more reference to the list, you can see that that reference is L, that's Lover. That automatically brought back the hyperlink that I deleted. So this is why you should not edit your reference in Word. Rather, go to the EndNote software itself, and then you want to create a window that's easy for you to work with. So on my left hand side, I have my library that contains the different group that I have in my EndNote. I have in the middle panel my bibliography, and on the right side it's displaying the document, which is the PDF of the reference. But a window is missing, and that is the window for editing the bibliography. So what I'm going to do is to look for this icon here on the right side of your screen at the upper ribbon in the Endnotes page. Click on it and select the right split. Clicking on the right split automatically opens this panel where you can easily edit the reference, the author name, or the title of the article. And for instance, remember we want to edit one of them. We have a situation whereby the journal name has been abbreviated. So what I'm going to do is to actually search for the article itself. So I'm going to go to Google Scholar, search for this. And what I'm going to then do is to click on it. And you can see that it belongs to, it's a PNAS paper. What I'm going to then do is to search the internet for PNAS. So that is the Proceedings of National Academy of Sciences. So I'll just copy that. Go to EndNote. And here, where we have it as abbreviated, I will just delete that and replace it with the new name, which is the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences. And then I'm going to the USA, that is kind of spaced out. I'll remove the space, the spacing, and then go back to my Word document and check which other one I want to edit. And in this instance, I want to, this last one, I need to change it that it contains the DOI. You can see that these are the DOI, but this does not. So what I would do is also to copy this particular article and then go to my Google Scholar and search for it. So this is the article here. And you can see this is where we have our DOI. So we are going to copy this DOI, excluding the HTTP and those strokes, because you do not want to copy a link. Rather, you just need the DOI number. Go back to your document, and then that should be this Tasaki. What I'm going to do is, instead of the URL, I'll just delete that and replace it with my DOI number. In some instances, if your EndNotes, if you're checking your EndNotes, another thing you should pay attention to for your references is that there are instances whereby the letter between your DOI, there are instances whereby you will have one that contains the letter as a capital letter. So if you're having that situation, let me see if I can find one of the reference that has such a situation. Can I remember any? No, I can't remember any for now, but I'm going to show you how to edit that. So imagine if one of these reference here, the same one we are editing, imagine if this the letters in between the DOI, if it is showing in capital, or let's, for instance, in this case, it's a small letter, and you want to make it a bigger case, that's a capital letter, what you are going to do is to highlight it, right click on it, and there is this part that says transformation. So you can choose if you want to make it an uppercase. Can you see that now we have that as uppercase, so that you can see what I'm saying clearly? What I'm going to do is to update this bibliography so that it's matching my correction. You can see when I clicked on update citation and bibliography, that hyperlink that was shown for this particular one, it's gone, and the other ones that contains the PNAS in abbreviation also has been corrected. You can see it's now showing as the full name, and we have here the one showing as a lowercase. So let me save that and then update this again. So when I update this, this small case should become a capital. So you can see what I mean now. Now this the alphabet between the DOI has been changed to capital. And that's because I changed it here. So after you finish modifying your EndNotes reference, one thing you should know is that you need to click away from that particular reference that you've modified. If you don't click away from it, the correction will not reflect when you click on update, but it will, in subsequent documents, it will. So let's change this back again to a smaller case. I will just click on this, highlight the four letters that I'm interested in modifying to lowercase, right click on the highlighted text, select transformations, and click on make lowercase. And because I'm still clicking, because my cursor is still on that particular reference, if I go here and I click update bibliography, it will not synchronize with my last edit. You can see that that capital is still showing. So it's important that you move away from, each time you move away from that modified reference, automatically that corrections, it's automatically saved. And if you then come back to your document and you click update citation, can you see that the modification has now been applied? And for so any other parts that you're looking to modify in your reference, it's a similar approach. Remember that you need to do your modification in EndNote, and that way it will synchronize when you come to your Word document. If you find my tutorial useful, please remember to click the subscribe button, and I'll see you in my next video. Until next time, bye.